Discover Africa's highest landowner, King Swati III, owning about 60% of Eswatini's land. Hello, Displorers! Welcome to another informative video presented to you by Displorer, and thanks for watching. The one thing Africa still has as an advantage over other continents is its vast vacant lands. Land cannot be supposedly owned by anyone, but in every country and continent, we have the huge landowners who acquire this through inheritance, purchase, or possession. In Africa, one of such owners is King Swati III of Eswatini, and in this video we shall take a biopic of this king and how he acquired his vast estates and wealth. But first, let us dig into this massive landowner's early life. If you are new here, welcome! Be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss any of our videos. Early life. Mswati III is one of many sons fathered by the previous king Sobhuza II, who had more than 125 wives during his reign of 82 years, and the only child of Ntombi Tswala, one of Sobhuza's younger wives. He was born at the Raleigh Fitkin Memorial Hospital in Manzini, 4 months before Eswatini attained independence from the United Kingdom. His birth name was Makosetif, translated Kings of Nations, in reference to the heads of state who visited Eswatini that year for the independence celebrations. As a young prince, Makosetif attended Masondwini Primary School and later Lusitu Palace School. He sat for the Swaziland Primary Certificate Examination in December 1982 at Pondo Royal Palace and received first class with merit in mathematics and English. He developed a great interest in the Royal Guard, becoming the first young cadet to join the Umbutfu Swaziland Defense Force. When King Sobhuza II died on 21st August 1982, the Great Council of State selected a 14-year-old prince, Makosetif, to be the next king. For the next 4 years, two wives of Sobhuza II, Queen Zeliwe Shongwe from 1982 to 1983 and Queen Ntombi Tswala from 1983 to 1986, served as regent while he continued his education in the United Kingdom, attending Sherborne School International College before he was called back to ascend to the throne. Kingship. Mswati was introduced as Crown Prince in September 1983 and was crowned king on 24th April 1986, aged 18 years and 6 days, and thus making him the youngest reigning monarch until the ascension of King Jigme Khesar Nyamgyel Wangchuck of Bhutan on the 14th of December 2006. He was also the youngest head of state until Joseph Kabila took office on January 26, 2001 as President of the Democratic Republic of Congo. The king and his mother, whose title is Ndlovukati, translated Great She-Elephant, ruled jointly. Today, King Swati III is Africa's last absolute monarch in the sense that he has the power to choose the prime minister, other top government posts and top traditional posts. Even though he makes the appointment, he still has to get special advice from the queen mother and council, for example when he chooses the prime minister. In matters of cabinet appointment, he gets advice from the prime minister. He ruled by decree, but did restore the nation's parliament, which had been dissolved by his father, in order to ensure concentration of power remained with the king. Wealth. Mswati has been criticized for his lavish lifestyle, especially by the media. In one report, he was accused of living a luxurious lifestyle while the people of his country starve. In the 2014 national budget, parliament allocated $61 million for the king's annual household budget, while 63% of Swazis live on less than $1.25 per day. Following criticism of his purchase of luxury cars, including the 500,000 Daimler Chrysler's flagship Maybach 62 luxury automobile, he banned the photography of his vehicles. According to Forbes 2009 list of the world's 15 richest royals, King Swati is worth a reported $200 million. In January 2004, The Times of Swaziland reported that the king asked his government to spend about $15 million to redecorate 3 main palaces and build others for each of his 11 wives. The Prime Minister's office issued a press statement saying the article in the Times of Swaziland was reckless and untrue, and that the proposal was for the construction of 5 state houses and not palaces, and the cost was only 19.9 million euro, which is ironically $24 million. Later that year, the go-ahead was given to build 5 new buildings at a cost of more than $4 million out of public funds. In August 2008, Swazi scouts marched through the capital, protesting the cost of a shopping spree taken abroad by 9 of the king's 13 wives. The demonstration was organized by Positive Living, a non-governmental organization for Swazi women living with AIDS. Mswati has a personal stake in a large portion of Eswatini's economy, which is a factor in its below-average economic growth for a sub-Saharan nation. As an absolute monarch, he holds the power to dissolve parties and can veto any legislation Parliament passes. Besides these, he is also one of the highest private landowners in Africa. The absolute ruler is the official owner of 60% of the country's land, which adds up to around 1 million hectares. Around 70% of the people who live in Eswatini live on land owned by the king, and through appointed officials, he has the ability to evict any citizen without having to support or compensate them in any way. Wives, concubines, and succession. A true polygamist like his father, King Swati currently has 15 wives and 23 children, and the king's first two wives are chosen for him by the national councillors. There are complex rules on succession. Traditionally, the king is chosen through his mother. As represented in the Swazi saying translated, a king is king through his mother. According to tradition, he can marry his fiancées only after they've become pregnant, proving they can bear heirs. Until then, they are termed lifovela or concubines. Controversies. Mswati's reign has brought some changes in the government and political transformation. However, critics such as the People's United Democratic Movement believe that these changes are solely aimed at strengthening and perpetuating the traditional order. Eswatini has been described as having been gripped by years of fiscal indiscipline, government corruption, and lavish lifestyles of the royal family. The nation has also been described as being on the brink of economic disaster due to these factors. Under Swazi law and custom, the king is vested with virtually all powers of the state. Despite Eswatini having a prime minister, Mswati holds supreme executive authority over the legislature and courts. Mswati's reign has been criticized for its several alleged human rights violations. His regime has been accused of using torture and excessive force to control the masses, as well as blatant discrimination against various dissenting groups. His regime has been accused of extrajudicial killings by his forces, along with arbitrary arrests, detentions, and unwarranted searches and seizures of homes and property. His government has restricted freedom of speech, assembly and association, and has harassed activists and journalists. The courts have taken little or no action to punish Mswati's actions or the officials who committed the abuses. He has been accused of kidnapping women he desires to marry, although no case can be brought against him. In addition, in 2000 he allegedly called for a parliamentary meeting to debate if HIV-positive people should be sterilized and branded. Strange country name change. On the 19th of April 2018, King Swati III changed the name of the country to Eswatini. The change was to mark the country's 50th anniversary of independence, even though the anniversary of the country's independence was indeed 6th of September of that same year. Given the king's birthday is on the 19th of April, guess the king was just renaming the country he owns to honor his birthday and signify his sovereignty over the land. Mswati III wanted the name Eswatini, which is the ancient original name for the country, and this change was to give up the previous colonial name, Swaziland. There you have it, Desplorers. That was a biopic of Africa's highest landowner, King Swati III. Thanks for watching this video, and if you did enjoy this video, do all to give the thumbs up, and do not forget to subscribe and share with your friends.